Before we get started, just like we start every class, take a moment to think, is there anything that you would like for us to know or like to share out just for the good of the group, the good of our community? Kayla?
I'm going to get new shoes.
Nice. We had a few new shoes in here. New shoes yesterday, right? And Michael, new shoes, right? Every day we start class with that question of, is there anything that you would like for us to know or like for you to share? And the purpose of that is to build that community. I don't ask them, how was your weekend? Not every student has a good weekend. I don't ask, what are you looking forward to this weekend? Because not every student has that. But we all have something that we can contribute to and learn about one another. That community piece really allows us to have those deeper conversations about curriculum and content. A lot of my math experiences that I provide for my students involve things that they are genuinely interested in.
So today we're going to continue to use this image, but we are going to be thinking about this as if we are talking about multiplication. Now, this is a pretty easy array to deal with because what array do we have here?
We have
1 by 2.
Array chats are a nice way for students to develop those foundational understandings of multiplication by looking at objects in rows and columns. And typically when you start out with those array chats, you gather a collection of images. I myself like to make learning a little bit more engaging for my students, so oftentimes the subject of my array chats are ridiculous things like toys that I had from a child. Recently I developed a series of array chats using Transformers heads. This allows students that level of comfort to participate in a conversation around something as silly as toys, but also pull out the mathematics behind it.
=32.
If you weren't quick at recall or you weren't the fastest student, it started to kind of poison your idea of like what makes someone a mathematician. So by including these different ways of learning, this being fluent with multiplication, we actually ensure more students have access to that. That math is not about memorization. It's also about that observation piece. It's also about thinking about things differently. So when we think about creating programs and activities for kids to interact with math, we want it to be interactive. We want them to be able to manipulate stuff. We want them to be able to try something out, not get it right, but not get penalized because they didn't get it right. That opportunity to experiment and experience the math. All of the experiences I have been given as a teacher in Fairfax County, all of the relationships I've built, all of the teachers that I still continue to work with, that may not be at my school, but we still communicate, we still support one another, we still reach out to one another when we're having those productive struggles. All of those key components got me to being that finalist, but it has not changed how I teach my students or the work I do every day or every night or on the weekends. The things that I'm doing in my classroom, in my 4 grade levels with my school, has not changed at all. But I see it making changes, and those changes being recognized means a great deal to all that have supported me throughout my career in Fairfax.
We were scheduled to be observed in 4th grade and filmed participating in an array chat. And unfortunately, I had a few students that were unable to attend due to prior commitments. As an educator, you know that you've really reached students and gotten them excited about learning when they are visibly upset that they could not be in class that day for that particular experience. So I touched base with a few of them and reached out to those that were recording us to see if it would be possible to share their arrays on here. And so these are some that have been created by 4th grade students at Armstrong around arrays. You can see here, Tavon created his 3x4 using a character from Fortnite. We had Annabelle, who created her array using a picture of a rabbit. Clara developed her array, her 4x5, using a picture of a puppy. We had Hava, who created her array a 4x6 utilizing a picture of a cat. Rylan decided to use the Chick-fil-A icon to create his 4x5 array as well.